सब्सक्राइब कीजिए नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी और एजुकेशनल वीडियोस सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम बैक अगेन विद अ न्यू वीडियो ऑन हडूप क्लस्टर इंस्टॉलेशन ऑन द स्पेशल रिक्वेस्ट ऑफ मैनी पीपल इन अवर टेलीग्राम चैनल। यू आर वॉचिंग नेहरा क्लासेस एंड आई एम योर फ्रेंड विकास नेहरा हेयर। फ्रेंड्स, इन टूडेज ट्यूटोरियल आई विल शो यू द मेथड ऑफ इंस्टॉलेशन एंड कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ हडूप वन नोड क्लस्टर इन रेड हैट एंटरप्राइज लिनक्स 8 और इन CentOS 8 बेस्ड मशीन्स। बट बिफोर दैट लेट मी गिव यू द ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ हडूप। अपाचे हडूप इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर यूटिलिटीज दैट फैसिलिटेट यूजिंग अ नेटवर्क ऑफ मैनी कंप्यूटर्स टू सॉल्व प्रॉब्लम्स इन्वॉल्विंग मैसिव अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा एंड कंप्यूटेशन। इट प्रोवाइड्स अ सॉफ्टवेयर फ्रेमवर्क फॉर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड स्टोरेज and processing of big data using MapReduce programming model. Originally designed for computers, clusters built from commodity hardware is still the common use. It has also found use on cluster of higher end hardware. All the modules in Hadoop are designed with a fundamental assumption that hardware failures are common occurrences and should be automatically handled by the framework. In today's tutorial, I am going to use this RHEL 8 machine where I will install and configure the Hadoop one node cluster. So without wasting our time, let's get started. Java is the primary requirement for running the Hadoop on any system. So first of all, we have to log in the machine as the root user, and we have to make sure that the localhost repository is already properly configured in our system. If you don't know how to configure it, you can watch my videos. I will provide you the link of those videos in the description as well as in the I button. So here you can see that I have already configured the localhost repository in my server. After that, I will install Java from this localhost repository in my machine. So for that, I can run this yum install hyphen y java command. So this command is installing the required packages in my machine. So you can see that the installation is going on. After the successful installation of these packages, we will verify whether these packages have been properly installed and or not. So for that, we can execute this java-version command. This command will show us the version of the installed Java package in our system. The installation of Java packages will hardly take 2 to 3 minutes, so you will have to wait till this process gets. So here you can see that the installation has been completed. Now we will verify with the help of java-version command. So it should show us the output like this: OpenJDK version 1.8.0. So we have successfully installed the Java in our system. After that, we will have to create Hadoop user. So it must be a normal user account. So what we are going to do here, we are going to add this Hadoop user in our system. So for that, we can execute user add Hadoop command. And after that, we will provide the password to this Hadoop account. You have to give the password twice here. So here we have set the password as well. Now in the next step, we will make an entry in the sudoers file for this Hadoop user so that he can execute some commands that requires admin privileges. हेयर मेंशन हडूप ऑल इज इक्वल टू ऑल ऑल और यू कैन मेंशन द कमांड्स. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप वी विल स्विच इन द अकाउंट ऑफ दिस हडूप यूजर बिकॉज फॉर द कॉन्फिगरेशन ऑफ हडूप वी विल यूज नॉर्मल यूजर अकाउंट. That is why we created this Hadoop user in our system. Now, what we will do, after the creation of account, it also requires to set up a key-based SSH to its own account. So for that purpose, we will generate a key with the help of SSH-keygen command like this. So we have generated the key. Now we will copy it in the authorized keys file with this command like this. Now in the next step we will set the permission 600 on this authorized key file. So we have set the permission as well. You don't need to worry about these commands. I will provide you all these commands in the description of this video, so you can copy these commands from there. Now we will verify whether we are able to SSH. So we will run SSH localhost command like this. So we are successfully able to SSH. Now we can exit. Now we will proceed towards the next step. Now we have to download the Hadoop archive file from the website. So for that we can execute this wget command like this. So what this command will do? This command will download the archive file in our home directory of this Hadoop user. It will take some time, so I'm going to pause the video. So you can see that I have successfully downloaded this Hadoop zip file in my Hadoop user home directory. Now in the next step we will unzip this zip file by using the tar command. So we are going to use tar xvf and the zip file name. So this command will unzip the files in directory, and this process will hardly take 1 to 2 minutes. So you need to wait till the time this unzipping process continues. After that, once the all files are unzipped, we will rename this Hadoop directory. You might have downloaded the different version of Hadoop. The directory with the same version So you can see that I have successfully unzipped the files. Now here you will find a Hadoop 3.1.0 directory unzipping in Hadoop user home directory. Now we are going to rename it. So to rename this, we can run the mv command. So simply we will execute the command like this. What it will do? It will just rename this Hadoop 3.1.0 directory to only Hadoop. Now, in the next step, we will set Hadoop sudo distributed mod. So, we will set up Hadoop environment variables. But before that, what we are going to do? We are going to just use this update alternatives command for Java. And we will copy the path of Java. So here first I will mention the password, and here we have to copy this path because in the upcoming steps we are going to use this path from this usr lib up to this jre. And after copying this path we have to paste it here
because in the upcoming steps we are going to use this path. Now here mention one and press enter. So we have run this command, we have copied the JRE path, Java path up to JRE. Now we need to set the environment variables that uses by Hadoop. So we can open the bashrc file in the VI editor like this, and here we will copy and paste all these lines in that particular file. These lines contains Java home, Java Hadoop home, Hadoop install, Hadoop mapred home, Hadoop common home, Hadoop SDFS home, yarn home. So all these variables we will paste here in this file. Just go in the insert mode and paste all these things. After that, save this file. Now we are good to proceed further. Now we need to apply these changes which we have mentioned in the bashrc file. So for that we can run source bashrc. So this command will set all these changes. Now in the next step we will edit this Hadoop -env.sh file that is inside the Hadoop folder which we have created after the extraction of the zip file. Now in this file what needs to be done, we have to mention this export java home, this complete path, but make sure that you mention the correct path which have you copied in the previous command. So let me copy and paste this path first here, and after that we will copy this entire line and paste it in the hadoop-env.sh file. So here first what we are going to do, we are going to just find this line where this export java is mentioned, export java home. So this is the line, export java home. We will first uncomment it, or we can remove the entire line and paste it here like this. So we have mentioned the details. Now save this file. Now in the next step we will set up the Hadoop configuration files. So Hadoop configuration files are present inside the etc Hadoop directory, that is in the Hadoop directory which we have extracted. So for that we have to go inside this Hadoop etc Hadoop with the cd command, and there if you will list the contents you will find several configuration files. So here we need to edit some files. So first file which we are going to edit is core-site.xml. So copy this file, open this file in the VI editor, go at the last line like this, and here we need to copy and paste all this stuff. Let me remove these configuration lines because my file already contains these details. And now save this. Now in the next step we will open the hdfs-site.xml file in the VI editor like this. Again go at the last line, and here we will copy and paste these lines. So let me first remove these configuration lines here, and now paste it. Save this file. Again open the mapred-site.xml file in the VI editor. Again go at the last line, remove these configuration lines. Like this. And paste these lines. You can copy all these lines from the description of the video. सेव दिस फाइल. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप ओपन यार्न हाइफन साइड डॉट एक्सएमएल फाइल इन द वीआई एडिटर. अगेन गो एट द लास्ट लाइन. Remove all this stuff and paste these lines there like this. Save the file. Now we have made the changes in the configuration files successfully. Now we will format name node. So for that we can run sdfs name node hyphen format command. It will take few seconds. So we will wait. Now in the next step, we will start the Hadoop cluster. So for that, we will first move inside the home Hadoop sbin directory. Let the process complete. After that, we will execute this command. Now we will execute this command and we will move inside sbin directory of Hadoop, and here we will run start dfs.sh script like this. Again it will take few seconds, so we will wait, and after the execution of this script we will execute the yarn.sh script. We have executed the yarn.sh. Now we can access the Hadoop services in the browser. So first let me check the IP address of my server. The IP address of my machine is 192.168.1.109. So with this IP address we will access it from the browser. What needs to be done there, we have to just mention the IP address and the port number, that is 9870. We have already mentioned all these details in the configuration files. So due to that we can access different things with different ports. Now here login as the root. Here I will open the web browser and mention these details like the IP address and the port number in the address bar of the web browser, and we will check whether we are able to access our Hadoop services in the browser or not. So here in the browser I will mention the IP address as well as the port number, and here it will show me the details of the services of Hadoop. So here you can see the overview summary. After this summary you can see the details about name node general status, name node storage, DFS storage type, and here in the summary tab you can see the details about live nodes, dead nodes. Live node is one, since we have only configured the single node cluster. Dead nodes are zero here. Capacity, DFS used, so all these details can be known with this port 9870. Now you can access port 8042 for getting the information about the cluster and all its applications. So for the information about the applications you can open the port number 8042 here in the address bar of the web browser after mentioning the IP address like this. So it will show you all these details. This can take few seconds. So here you can see that what are the details अबाउट दिस एप्लीकेशंस, व्हाट इज़ द टोटल मेमोरी, वर्चुअल मेमोरी एलोकेटेड फॉर द कंटेनर्स, वर्चुअल मेमोरी एनफोर्समेंट, फिजिकल मेमोरी एलोकेटेड, फिजिकल मेमोरी एनफोर्समेंट, वर्चुअल कोर्स. सो ऑल दीज डिटेल्स कैन बी नोन फ्रॉम दिस टैब. लिस्ट ऑफ एप्लीकेशंस, इफ़ यू विल क्लिक ऑन दिस टैब, यू विल गेट द डिटेल्स अबाउट द लिस्ट ऑफ द एप्लीकेशंस. सो विद दिस पोर्ट नंबर 8042, यू कैन गेट ऑल दीज डिटेल्स. सो देर आर नो एप्लीकेशंस रनिंग सिंस वी हैव नॉट स्टार्टेड एनी एप्लीकेशन हेयर. नाउ यू कैन एक्सेस पोर्ट 9864 टू गेट द डिटेल्स अबाउट योर हडूप नोड. So let me copy and paste it in the browser. Here I will show you. So here you can get these details about the data nodes. What is the cluster ID? What is the version? Block pools. You can get the volume information. So all these details can be known with this port 9864. Guys, in case you need to check the logs, whether the system logs or the user logs, or you need to browse the features of this Hadoop 3.1.0, you can use this port number 9870. Mention this port after the IP address like this, and if you will click on this utilities tab, you will find several options. Here you can browse the file system like this. If you will click here, you can browse the file system. You can see the logs in this logs tab. These are the system logs. For the user logs, you can click here in this user logs link. You can see the metrics here. You can see the configuration files. What are the configuration settings in this configuration tab? And you can see the process thread dump as well. So if you'll click here, you can see the process thread dump. So guys, this was all about the configuration and installation of Hadoop 3.1.0 in RHEL 8 or in CentOS 8. Hope you would have enjoyed this video. If you like my hard work, then please give a like to this video and do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, then please subscribe our channel and turn on the bell notification for the latest updates. I will keep providing you more videos on RHEL 8 in the upcoming days. I will see you in any other session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.